Okay, welcome to another Aries Wave Ethereum price action update. So we have invalidated the previous idea already, right? Because if you remember, and by the way, I don't normally cover ETH, but this is my second video for today, so go figure. So basically what's happened here is I said that if we break down below this level, then we'll go lower. What happened? It turned around. So that means we've got to go back and analyze the pattern because obviously something was missed. Okay, and I can do that right now. So first things first, let's take a look at the first move down. And I had a quick look at this because this is my second take on this video. The first one failed to upload, unfortunately. So we've got to be honest with ourselves here, and we've got to understand that this does not look like a five wave move. Okay, wave three in the middle, non-existent. Okay, originally I thought, oh, this could be three wave move, you know, that type of thing, right? You skim and you shouldn't skim, but right now it's become pretty obvious that there's a five wave move followed by like a 3-3-5-3-5 or what have you, right? It looks more like a zigzag because there's only one pattern that happens after a five-wave move. It's either a five-wave move or a zigzag, and it depends on what the previous five-wave move was all about. So in saying that, that means that we had the A wave occur, okay? So obviously, you know, I like to color my labels, so I'm just going to do that for you so you can try and illustrate. So I already went through this and the B wave was here. As I mentioned, this is my second take, so had a bit of practice already. This is a C wave. Okay. Sorry, let me try that again. This is the C wave. Okay, and this can only be counted as a D wave because the next move is a five wave move down. So when some waves are hard to distinguish, it's usually the one that is missing. So 3-3-5-3-5, that's the key combination. Don't make it your passcode in case someone knows RS wave and they guess it on you. And you can probably guess right now, not many people. So therefore, what does that mean? It means that, okay, we never broke the magenta line. That's invalidated. Okay, so the magenta line was now here. Down here is your critical support. Okay, your critical support is here. So now we're in the third of a third wave. Okay, so this is wave two. So obviously we're going to move much, much higher. Okay. This is the beginning of a larger move. Now, that means that up here we have, wait, sorry. Let me fix this chart up. It's just going all over the place. So that's wrong. That's A, that's B, that's C. Actually, what happened here is there's a CDE pattern scenario going on. Okay, I think there's still that E there. That can happen sometimes. And what happened to my one? Sorry, I didn't even put my one there. Okay, so that's one. Okay, and I'll copy that there, change it around. So the first wave one and two, I usually make blue, and then any wave three price action is usually green. So for me right now, this looks like the beginning of a five wave move up, and it's only just getting started. Okay. So I'll explain to you in a moment what that entails. So I still believe that this is a wave one down. So from my previous analysis, I said this is a wave one down. That's fine. I still believe that's true. The only difference is that basically we are looking for a five wave move up that's going to be part of a zigzag, which this is not. This is not a complete correction. This is just, it appears to be part of a larger move up for wave A of a wave A. Yeah. Wave A in brackets of a wave A. So look, I'm telling you, you should really learn this stuff, because otherwise my members will understand this video, because I post all my videos to the private Facebook group. So if you go and pull a retracement, you know, fib retracement on this, 50% is all the way up here. Okay, so, you know, corrections can go, you know, 0.618, they can even go 0.786, right? The point is to understand what's going on. So what I'm trying to say here is that we're looking at like potentially like a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 scenario, right? And then we could see like a pullback, right? It could be like, you know, like a pretty decent pullback, and then another five wave move. It could be like a double top scenario. Right, this is exaggeration, right? But I mean, have a look at how high that wave one's gone, right? And there's another alternative case for this, but at this point in time, I'm just going to assume that we're just going to get like basically like, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then a pullback, whatever that is, and then back up to 0.618 or 0.786. As long as it doesn't go above the top, I'm not going to assume that it's something else, which it could be, depending on the pattern. Like, as I mentioned before, I think this is a giant B wave. But just in case it isn't, then if this happens to be an A wave, then the B wave would ensue. There's no telling at this point, because there's just not enough evidence. But if you look at the Bitcoin chart, then it suggests that, yeah, that's the type of thing that we're looking at here. So excuse me. So at this point in time, I can't say that's an A wave completed there. At the small degree, we just had a correction, and it appears that it's going to go higher. Okay, so definitely something has triggered the next move up. We're in an uptrend. It's a bear market rally. I can actually say that with a good level of confidence. It's a bear market rally, and I expect price to move up right from here straight up. Like, if you thought this was sharp here, then I think it's just going to get sharper. Okay, and that's interesting too, because it's going to obliterate that long term moving average. So it wasn't resistance. In fact, it was just a call for a correction, and then it's just going to blast through it. Okay, so that's in a nutshell what I'm seeing. So yeah, look, at this stage it's really hard to know what's going to happen, but we can follow the five wave move. So for now, let's just do that. Let's not jump the gun, because I can always come out with a billion different ideas on what's going to happen. Because remember, we're dealing with fractal patterns. So it's anyone's guess at the moment. All bets are off, especially with cryptos and the potential for recession and the potential for stagflation, where markets slowly grind down. So we will have more of an idea if that's going to happen soon, depending on how high this move goes. If it goes up to 50%, there's a chance that if it has a really deep retracement, then it could come back up for the C wave. But if it goes too high, chances are that it's not that. Chances are that we're in a larger B wave, and then the previous move since the start of the year was the end of a five-wave move, even though at this point in time, I don't think that's the case. Okay, so I suppose the only thing else to say now is, well, if this is five-wave moves up and we've just had this sideways correction, then expect higher prices. If you're the kind of person who likes to have a target, to me, I would take the length of wave one and I'd double it from this point here. Okay. So I'd go up until around 2,400 roughly, right? But there's definitely money to be made in this move. That's why my only concern is if we do get that type of move, what's the wave four or five going to look like? How high is that going to go? Hopefully it just goes to 50%, and a good deep retracement would definitely help it pump back up to 0.618, maybe even higher. But it gives us a little bit of a roadmap. If we see this thing go absolutely stupid parabolic, obviously we know that it's not going to continue lower. So I don't know how many times I've got to repeat that, but I just feel like it's really important, especially because when you start off a move like this, you know, it starts off all nice and calm and relaxed, and then it just goes boom. You know, like, what is that? Is that the start of a big move? Because if you look at it on a daily time frame, take away all the drawings, you know, it just looks, sorry, I just put drawing back on. It just looks like the start of a new trend, right? So that's where we're going to be careful, is understanding what are the different potentials, what are the different patterns it could be forming. And I can think of, you know, a few, as I've mentioned. But the key here is to understand how waves work. Either follow me, learn RS Wave, join the groups, and you know, there's tons of other ways to make money. There's tons of other coins that do make money all the time, regardless of market conditions. It's just the pattern. It's all about the pattern. Okay, so hopefully you found this second update for Ethereum in one day helpful and informative. Thank you for watching.